This video tutorial I will explain what is WSDL and UDDI. First we will see what is web services and then we will see how WSDL and UDDI will fit into web service architecture. Web services is nothing but services available over the web, and using web services we can enable communication between two applications. Here you can see the application which is developed using Java and running on Windows operating system. And this application uses Oracle database. And here you can see the application developed using .NET and it is running on Linux operating system. And it uses MySQL database. Using web services, we can enable communication between these two different applications. Here you can see the server or service provider which will expose the web service, and here you can see the client or service consumer which will consume the web service. Suppose you are the service consumer, then service consumer needs to know what are the different services are available, what are the request parameters and what are the response parameters, and how to call the web service. So what service provider will do is, service provider publishes an interface for his web services, and that interface describes all the attributes of the web services, and that interface is XML based and it is called web services description language, and it is also called WSDL. WSDL is XML based interface, and WSDL is used to describe the functionality of the web services. And WSDL is XML based because it is machine readable, and using some tool or programming language we can generate request and response structure. Now we will see one sample WSDL file. In Google I searched online WSDL, and here I got calculator WSDL. I am opening this. Here you can see calculator WSDL. And it is in XML format, and it defines what are the different functionalities supported by calculator web service, and also it describes what are the different requests it support, what are the different request parameters, what are the different response. Everything is defined here. To expose web services, what service provider will do is, service provider creates an WSDL, and service consumer get the WSDL and use the web service or consume the web service. There are two ways service consumer can get WSDL file from service provider. The first way is, if service provider knows service consumer, then service provider can directly hand over WSDL document or WSDL URL to service consumer. Then service consumer can use that WSDL and consumes the web service. Suppose service consumer does not know who is the service provider. In that case, how service consumer will get WSDL file from service provider? In this case, we can use a second approach. In this case, service provider publishes his web service through WSDL on an online directory or registry which is called UDDI, and from this registry the service consumer can search the web service and get the WSDL, and then using the WSDL the service consumer can consume the web service. UDDI stands for Universal Description, Discovery and Integration, and it is an XML based standard for service provider to publish the web service through WSDL and service consumer finding the web services. In UDDI registry, different service providers will publish WSDL related to their own web service. Then what service consumer will do is, they will search the web service which they want to use in UDDI registry, and once they find the particular web service, they will get the WSDL, and using the WSDL they will consume the web service. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more, and here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.